Here are three things that you need to do when you change planners. Stay tuned. Hello and welcome back to my channel. Now, whether you are looking for your perfect planner, your unicorn planner piece, or you saw something that you really like on Instagram and you want to try it out, there are a few things you should think about before switching your planner or switching your planner system. This could be anything from going from horizontal to vertical or going from daily to weekly or anything in between. Your planner needs to be your minion. It needs to work for you in a way that helps you not only stay organized, but be productive, motivated, and get everything done that you need to do so that you can do all those other fun things that you really want to do. Your planner is your minion, so it needs to work for you. You shouldn't have to adapt your habits and the way you plan to fit something made out of paper, something that was designed for someone else and how they plan. There are three things that you can do when you make a switch from one planner or one planner system to another. I'll get to those in just one second, but I wanted to talk about my story a little bit because I thought it would help someone else to get an understanding of where I've come up with these tips and why they're helpful. I recently made a switch from a weekly planner to planning daily. I didn't think that I needed a daily plan because most of those daily planner pages are just full of things and it just takes too much time to fill it all out. And even if I did fill out all the different sections of these daily planners, I wasn't actually looking back through them throughout the day, so they were basically useless. And I also found that the pages that I was using to try this out were just too big. Then out of the blue, the perfect planner was gifted to me. It basically fell into my lap. It was exactly what I was looking for. The pages were small, about A5, and they had just the things on it that I needed. So it seemed perfect. And I started using it, but then a big problem kind of popped up. The things that I wasn't getting done were getting lost. In my weekly planner, I was circling the things that I didn't finish at the end of the day, and the next day, or even further in the week, I would see what wasn't getting done, and it was really easy for me to be able to pick those up. But with the daily pages, I turned that page and I was on the next day. I couldn't easily see what I wasn't getting done. And it wasn't intuitive for me at the end of the day to go rewrite them on the next day. You know how it is at the end of the day, you're just tired and you don't want to do that sort of thing. And circling things was really working for me, and I wanted to be able to move that forward because if it ain't broke, you don't want to fix it. And then on a call with my Australian friends, they came up with the idea of having a weekly list. I tried that out. It was working great. And a few days later, I stumbled on a Post-it list, and I've been using that ever since, and it is the perfect combination. So this planner can be on a pad on my desk, or if I need it to be portable, it is completely portable. Not that I can go many places with my planner at the moment, but that's beside the point. It's working well for me. Okay, let's move on to those three things that you need to do when you change your planner. Number one is to assess your current situation in the planner that you're using before the switch. Most importantly, what is working? Really pay attention to what you like about this planner. Sometimes you don't even notice it until you make that switch, but that's okay because we're going to get to that in a little bit. It's always that squeaky wheel that gets the grease, so you pay attention more to the things that aren't working for you, and the things that are working just sort of work along behind in the background and you don't notice them. So that's when my third tip, number three, will come into play, and we'll get to that in just a second. Also, look at those squeaky wheels. Write those down as well. Those are the things that you want to tweak and change and improve upon with the new planner. If you are enjoying this video so far, please give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Next week, I'll be back with an August plan with me, so make sure you have your notifications turned on so you don't miss that. Okay, let's get back into tip number two. Number two is the fun part. You are going to research new planners and try them out. A lot of planner companies will have free printables online that you can use to test out their planner pages. So I highly suggest that you print off a week's worth or so and use those and see how it works for you. It's a lot easier and a lot cheaper to practice on these printables than to buy the planner to then have to either throw it away or give it away if it doesn't work for you. If they don't have free printables, sometimes you can buy an outdated planner for really cheap. So you can buy last year's planner and try that out and then just change the dates on a week or so and try it out. Okay, number three, this is also very fun. You want to make the switch. You want to try out your brand new planner. You want to live with it for a while, and then, like me, you'll notice the things that aren't working. and you can assess those and tweak as necessary. And it might not just be one tweak and then you're done. You're going to want to tweak and tweak and tweak until you find the perfect combination for your life situation right now. You can research planners all day long and think that you found the perfect planner for you, but research is not a substitution for actual trial and error. You can't tell from a computer screen how this planner is going to work for you until you actually have it in your hands and see how it works. And of course, your planner needs are going to evolve and change over time. So your planner that works for you now may not work for you next year or in 5 years, and it may not be the same planner that worked for you last year or 5 years ago. Knowing that your planner needs evolve over time makes it easier to switch planners, because sometimes you can get really attached to a planner that worked perfectly for you at a certain point in time, but now it no longer suits your planner needs. Sometimes it's hard to let go, but if you know that your needs are evolving, then it makes it easier to switch or just tweak your current planner. Sometimes planner girls will stick with the same planner for years and years and it works great for them. Other planner girls like to change it up on a regular basis just for the fun of it. So knowing what you need out of a planner will help make that switch a little easier and also keep it fun. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Like I said, next week I will be doing my August plan with me, so you won't want to miss out on that. Coffee's kicking in, I can feel the jitters. Okay, too much time to fill up. Okay, put this at the very beginning. You can subscribe here by clicking on my little face. Here are two more videos that I think you will like. If you made it this far, leave me your favorite smiley face emoji in the comments below. Have a fantastic day and happy planning.